Once you've successfully connected to the dedicated cloud instance, accessing LLM DataStudio becomes effortless through the App Store, given its integration within the H2O Cloud platform. Simply type H2O LLM DataStudio in the search menu to find the application. Then, please click on the tile with the same name to begin exploring the application. Once you've clicked on it, press the Run button to create a new instance that will be available for you to use. Once the setup is complete, a new window will open, providing you with full access to the LLM DataStudio interface. Let's take some time to explore this interface and its functionalities. The home page serves as the landing page and provides a brief introduction to LLM DataStudio. It is a user-friendly, no-code interface designed to streamline data preparation tasks for LLMs, large language models. These tasks include continuing pre-training and fine-tuning for different tasks such as text summarization, human-bot conversation, instruct tuning, and more. Pause briefly to delve into the diverse techniques supported by LLM DataStudio. When you're prepared, let's move forward to the remarkable Curate section to initiate our data curation endeavors. The Curate feature within LLM DataStudio is an exceptional tool that will help you save valuable time with your data restructuring process. It is a no-code feature that simplifies the process of creating a question and answer dataset from your unstructured data. With this capability, you can build your dataset without needing to write code. LLM DataStudio accepts various types of input documents, such as PDFs, docx, and TXT files, as well as audio files like MP4 and .wav, or even a zipped file combining these formats. This input is utilized to curate a question-answer dataset for the purpose of fine-tuning your own LLM. The Curate functionality employs intelligent chunking, embeddings, prompt engineering, and H2O GPT LLMs. It generates question-answer pairs using the input documents or audio as context for the language model. The resulting output is a dataset comprising question and answer pairs. These question and answer pairs can be downloaded, reviewed manually, or imported into a prepare project for further refinement and cleaning. Next up, the prepare tab, which is a feature that proves to be an invaluable asset in streamlining and structuring your data preparation assignments. Every individual project is dedicated to a particular data readiness task, simplifying the process of monitoring numerous projects concurrently. Further insights into this section will be provided in the upcoming modules. Beneath the projects feature, you'll discover the data catalog containing information about augmentation datasets. These datasets can be augmented with your input datasets in the configuration screen within a project. In this section, you will find the table displaying various dataset details, including the dataset name, description, workflow types, number of rows and columns, dataset URL, and the associated license. Feel free to click on any dataset to view its rows. For example, let's click on the first dataset, Stanford Q&A dataset. Presented here is a preview of the first 100 rows from a vast dataset containing 5,000 rows. This dataset is known as the Stanford Question Answering Dataset and comprises questions posed by crowd workers on a set of Wikipedia articles, where the answer to each question is sourced from the corresponding reading passage. To return to the LLM Studio Data Catalog page, simply click on the X button located at the top right side of the screen. Once there, let's explore the info section on the left side. In the first section, called Help Guide, User Interface App, you'll find valuable insights about the user interface of LLM DataStudio, which is designed for simplicity and accessibility. Additionally, you'll discover more about project components, the supported workflows in LLM DataStudio, such as question answering, text summarization, instruct tuning, human-bot conversations, and continued pre-training. These workflows are complemented by essential functionalities like data augmentation, text cleaning, profanity, and quality checks, padding, truncation, etc. The second tab provides valuable resources in the form of a help guide and Python API. LLM DataStudio offers a comprehensive help guide center along with a Python API for seamless integration. You can learn how to prepare a Q&A dataset using the API, unlocking new possibilities for your data preparation tasks. Lastly, in the Importance tab, you'll gain valuable insights into the significance of cleaned data. Cleaned data plays a vital role in enhancing model performance, generalization, language understanding, and ethical outcomes. Therefore, meticulous curation and validation of data are essential to ensure reliable and fair models for real-world applications. As your first assignment, please dedicate 10 to 15 minutes to thoroughly review the content of the three informational tabs before progressing. I anticipate our rendezvous in the next module, where we will delve deeper into conversations concerning the project tab. Cheers! In the previous module, we explored the LLM DataStudio interface and found an awesome feature focused on data curation. An important capability about LLM DataStudio is that it can automatically change different types of files, like PDFs and audio files, into sets of question-answer pairs without needing people to do it. LLM DataStudio can handle PDFs and audio files like MP3 and WAV. It makes question-answer pairs by breaking down documents smartly, picking out useful parts, and using one of H2O's own fine-tuned LLMs. In this process, you can say certain pairs of questions and answers don't matter if they are not connected. The next release of LLM DataStudio will allow easy connectivity with the prepare functionality to augment, filter, and format these QA pairs to use with H2O LLM Studio. This update comes out with a complete guide too, which you can find on the App Store. Let's go through each step in this workflow. In this example, we will start by clicking into the Data Studio's curation part. This is where the smart system takes care of your starting documents. It figures out important parts, breaks them down, and makes them into question-answer pairs. Clicking the new button makes it easy to make a new project. We begin with uploading any documents, which could be PDFs, audio, or video. These different types of content are the building blocks that get better as we go through the process. For example, let's say we have a PDF called h2ogpt.pdf. We upload it into a new project in LLM DataStudio and name it H2OGPT Paper. We can write a description and then hit the upload button to put the PDF into LLM DataStudio. Next, we move on to the DataStudio's curate configurations and click Run. Please keep an eye on the logs on the right side of the screen. They show what's happening as our project goes forward. During this process, the logs show us what's going on. Clicking Reload gives us more info about how the files are being processed. How long this takes depends on the file's size. LLM DataStudio is making Q&A pairs from the text parts pretty much from the beginning. Finally, we get to the end of the process where we are able to download our results in a JSON or a CSV format and prepare for the next stages of fine-tuning.